That was OC Remix number 3132. 3132. 3D Pinball, Space Cadet, Interstellar, Sasuke, spelled with fives, five ever. Pinball by Sir Jordanius. Jordanius? Sir something.
Can you imagine if the McElroys are still trying to name, like, name years, like, 1,000 years from now?
Oh, yeah.
Somehow.
I can imagine. What do you think 3164 is going to be called?
31 anymore.
Good. Good, I'm so glad. There we go. Mic's peaking a little. Hopefully it doesn't come through in the audio.
Yeah.
Not much I can do about it. Just RN noise has decided it's going to be RN noise today.
So let's do the thing. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, friends beyond the binary, hello and welcome. I'm Christy here on your Monday. I'm here with Katie.
What up?
You've heard that before, but now it's official.
Hooray.
It's been made official now.
It's like we got married.
It's like we got married or something. Like we did several years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to play some Game Dev Story, which I'm excited about. It's a game by Kairosoft, as you can tell by the little Kairosoft robot up there in the top left of the frame.
Their name is Kairobot, and they're the main character of everything, whether you like it or not.
Mascots, right? What are you going to do?
How's everyone doing?
Hi, Andy. Hi, Mox.
I'm opening a Pepsi.
I've opened a pre-made mojito. That's quite...
Oh, yeah, that's louder than expected.
Can we make that slightly not louder?
There we go. That's its correct volume. I forgot to set it before the stream.
I'm going to set the mojito here among the Pirates Lego build. I feel that's good.
Yes.
Let's create a new game.
Sunny. See, they always just go with Sunny. That's like their thing.
Where? How do we want to identify ourselves as a gaming company? Do we want to be Truck Gaming? Do we want to be Truck Studios? I have a body and it's terrible.
Me too.
Same hat. There's a lot of that going around.
My body has weird growths.
My body is a blunderland. That's one of those jokes I always have in my hip pocket.
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad to finally get to use it on something. any preference how we want to do this?
Well, let's see. What's least likely to get shut down by EA in a fit of we're not making enough money?
Oh. Truck Entertainment? That makes it sound like it's not a gaming studio. That means EA isn't even going to try to buy us.
Ah, good idea.
Yeah.
They give you way more letters on this version than in the, fucking phone version.
Yeah. Hello! I'll be your secretary here at Truck Entertainment. I look forward to working with you, whether you're an expert or this is your first time. I'll do whatever I can to help you make a best-selling game. Maybe you can even win the grand prize in the Global Game Awards. If you ever have any questions, just tap System. Tap.
Wow.
On the game menu and select Manual.
You can tell they put a lot of... Oh, I guess it's supposed to be handheld mode. But you'd think they would have changed it for, you know, added extra tutorials for the... It's not a very complex port job.
No, but as long as it's Game Dev Story, I think we're going to have fun with it.
Mm-hmm.
They did fix the interface,
mm-hmm.
So that looks quite good.
Mm-hmm.
We can see here it's year one, month four, week one, and we have $500,000. Which sounds like a lot, but we are going to go into the red almost immediately. I'm letting you all know that. It's fine.
So one of the things that really bothers me about this game and the other games that use the same type of gameplay from this studio is that Well, let's get into actually making our first game, and I'll explain it there.
This might be a good time, though, to say that Kairosoft makes a lot of games like this, mostly for mobile.
Mm-hmm.
And I quite like them. I think they're good at this kind of game.
Yep.
They're not all winners, Kairosoft games, but this is one of my favorites.
They're like $7.50 on mobile, but for some reason they're like $15 on Switch.
Yeah, I think part of that is the Nintendo cut.
I don't know who takes a bigger cut, Nintendo or Google.
Or Apple.
Or Apple.
I took my glasses off so that I could rub my eyes, and now I can't read anything. First of all, you'll need to hire some employees. Open the menu and select staff. Greater than, hire. R to menu. And when we're in the menu, everything freezes.
Mm-hmm.
So that's good. Let's hire some staff.
I think that is like the Snyder cut, yes.
Word of mouth magazine ad. Let's just go cheap.
Yeah, I always want to start out with the cheap stuff.
I'll ask around and see what I can FI.
Wow, this is not a good port, huh?
I'll let you know if I hear of any promising candidates. I think we can forgive them a little bit of wonkiness in the dialogue windows. I think that's okay, as long as the gameplay is fine.
Morning!
The results of the word of mouth from the other day are here. That makes more sense when you choose, like, newspaper ad or something.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, we got two applicants. Who should we hire? You can see past records by moving the scroll bar down.
So we got California.
California. She's a sound engineer. It's
video game related.
She's a sound engineer with 13 sound. That doesn't mean a lot to us right now.
Mm-hmm. Or Android, who not only has a much cooler name, she's also better at everything.
Yeah. She's cheaper to hire. The only, like, downside, it would be that she has slightly less, you can see her power bar there.
Which is stamina, I believe?
Yeah, it's stamina. It means she cannot work for quite as long before needing to take a break.
How much is her salary compared to Cali?
Cheaper.
Wow.
Because California, as you can see there, is a level 3 sound engineer.
Wow, and therefore, stats are worse.
Yeah, and their stats are worse. Wow, what happened? Oh, you're a level 2 coder also.
Oh, she's dual class.
Oh, yeah, that's why. And Android's just a level 1 sound engineer.
I mean, we could afford both of them.
Right, but we can only hire one, I think. We only have one open desk.
Oh, okay. I would go with Anne regardless.
Yeah.
Truck E Entertainment.
You want to read the whole dialogue window?
No.
Okay. But hiring, yes.
Well,
oh, no, that's me.
Yeah, you've got two of
them. Okay, guests. Whoops.
That's fine. Who needs a coder?
Who do we have? Who's our...
Got Noob Ownerton.
A level 1 coder.
He owns noobs, you see.
John Gameson, a level 1 writer.
So the other person wouldn't have been great at graphics anyway, which is what we're missing.
Yeah, so let's... No, I don't want to train anybody.
Work! Exclamation point.
Let's go to staff and try to hire... Let's see if we can't get an artist in here. Robot girl, listen.
The results of the word of mouth from the other day are here.
We got 3 applicants. Callie is trying again.
Yeah.
Biggs Porkins is here.
Wow, that's a Star Wars reference.
Graphics 2.
She's a writer.
Yeah,
we're still not getting any artists.
3. Graphics 10. I think maybe we should hire Callie just.
Yeah. Better than nothing.
Yeah, better than nothing. All the names are like that. You can't do ellipses at all of these names because they are all like that.
The chat will just be all ellipses within minutes.
Get it out of your system. Put as many dots in chat as you need to right now, and then we'll get back to it. Yes, quit hiring.
Racing genre unlocked for hiring 2 employees.
Yeah, we can make a racing. Probably.
Start on making a game.
Yeah, we should probably develop a game. Well, I think we can't develop a new game. I think we should take a contract?
I guess. That gets us the quickest profits.
Yeah, it does. Also, it means that we can avoid, like, graphics here.
Game scenario, game comic, or pinball movie.
Yeah. Mm. I do love pinball.
The contracts do take 10 weeks, though.
It's due in 10 weeks. It takes however long.
You can do it quicker?
Yeah.
I love most of them, but Big Sporkins was a trench run too far.
The rest are just solid Ace Attorney names.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, let's do a game scenario because we don't have to do any graphics. We just need to put out 5 programming and 30 scenario points.
Mm-hmm.
And it actually pays the most on this list.
Yeah.
You took the game scenario job. The deadline is in 10 weeks.
A he deadline.
Let's go, everybody. I didn't even notice it. Oh.
The latest issue of Game Guy magazine has arrived.
Competition in the game industry continues to heat up. Excuse me, I'm going to try again. Competition in the game industry continues to heat up as newcomer Truck Entertainment enters the market. We look forward to seeing what they have in store for us.
I want to point out on that page real quick, back. You notice how industry is cut into pieces, but newcomer isn't?
Yeah.
That's really strange.
Yeah, I don't know why it's like that. Like, they have word wrap on, it's just...
It just doesn't work sometimes.
Yeah. It will need to be impressive to make an impact in this crowded market.
This crowded video game market.
Yeah. And so this is what it is.
It is a lot of this.
It's a little bipping and bopping. Everyone's working their hardest.
Oh shit!
Someone's on a streak.
He's on fire. Ooh, now they're working together.
So what's the game scenario we're writing?
Okay. Okay. So there's this zombie who wakes up in a jail.
Okay.
Yeah. And someone throws a key down on their head.
Uh-huh.
And then they're not told what to do, except that everything is completely explained in a long tutorial that culminates in killing a demon, but then everyone will say there was no tutorial.
And then everyone gets killed by the demon.
And then everyone gets killed by the demon, and that's the end of the game.
Good. That's a great game. It's very challenging. The work for the game scenario, J-Ob, is now complete. We should submit it to the client.
Shouldn't talk about J-Obs on Twitch.
I don't know what that's referencing, and I'm afraid.
Well done. I hope to work with you again.
We got some money and some research data, which is what the floppy drive is there at the top left.
Mm-hmm.
We can spend that if we don't want to do something.
Yep.
You've stored up a lot of research data, haven't you? The number next to the floppy disk icon and the... Okay, secretary. You didn't have to do me like this. Use it to level up your staff or improve the game you are developing. Okay, instead of that...
See ya!
Instead of that, let's go to our... Nope. Instead of that, let's go to one of our sound engineers.
Callie. She's going to be working on the graphics. Wow.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I think that we should take someone and just turn them into
an artist. Callie's the one to probably turn into a graphic.
Oh, because she already has much higher graphics.
No, Anne has higher graphics.
Oh, okay.
Anne also has higher sound.
Yes. I'm sorry. I forgot which one of these was which.
Mm-hmm.
Train, that's not what that means. This is a different thing, where you can send someone to go for a walk, and then maybe they think about video games on their walk, and they come back with a new genre for you.
Yeah, you gotta hit level up to use research points.
Level up. California.
That only levels her up in her current job.
Oh, right. We need an item to actually change jobs. It's called a job change manual or something.
Yeah.
Well, now she's a level 4.
She can still work on graphics, but she's not going to level up in graphics as quickly.
Yeah. You level up one of your staff members. When you level up an employee, their parameters go up, and you may unlock new game genres. But their salary also goes up. Make sure you have enough money to pay them. Yes. I will totally do that. Let's make a game.
Let's do it.
Let's make a new game.
So as I was saying, the thing I don't like about this game...
Okay.
Keep going in until...
Oh, I wanted to read the dialogue window.
Okay.
Now we will come up with a proposal for the new game. You can change the genre and type by pressing the OK key. Okay, so...
Okay, so what it shows here...
Uh-huh.
You see they've got genre and type...
Yep.
And platform and all that.
Yeah.
You can pick any genre...
Yeah.
And then any type and combine them together.
Yeah.
The thing is, I'll put in something that I think sounds really cool, like click into genre.
Okay.
Like, I would put together a, let's say, puzzle.
Okay.
Now go into type. And, let's just stick with pirate. It's a puzzle pirate, you know?
Like that game Puzzle Pirate.
Something that you'd swear would be, like, really successful. You've got a puzzle game that's themed around pirates, which is awesome.
I'm pretty sure Puzzle Pirates was an actual game that did well.
And a huge hit that's still going today.
Yeah.
And the problem is, I know for a fact that this genre and type combination gets you something that is considered a complete failure because they don't go together.
Well, not a failure, but it's a much more difficult sell, which is weird.
Anytime it says it's a much more difficult sell, though, that means you are going to make less money on it.
Period. Yeah. So the thing about it is that, like, you're correct, and the one that struck me was, what was it? Puzzle Exploration?
Uh-huh.
Which, that's just missed. That's the reason, the one of the most popular games of all time, which is why I put them together.
Mm-hmm.
And it just kind of went, I don't know about that one, boss.
So there's a lot of guesswork involved as to what the developers thought were good combinations.
Yeah. So PC game, which costs us $10,000 to just dev for.
Because there's no license involved.
Yeah, or we could negotiate for a license with the Microsex.
The Microsex.
With the Microsex, it would cost us $200 up front, and then we would also have a dev cost.
Mm-hmm.
But do we want to do that? You can see there. You can see how many units that they have sold. 820. So at a max, this could get into 820,000 hands. The game for this.
Also, they have a 62% market share.
Yeah.
Which is fucking wild.
So the thing about what's good about the PC is that it never, like, consoles will come and go, and there's a dev license cost for each of them. But the PC always sticks around and is always cheap to develop for.
It never has the highest market share.
No. Do we want to
get this? Yeah, let's just go for the PC first.
Well, I'm afraid we can't allow a company with no experience to have a license for our console, says our own secretary. Why don't you start out by developing some PC games? Or maybe it's a different secretary, but the...
All secretaries look identical in this game.
Which is a shame. Do we want to do a Puzzle Pirate game?
Let's see what's available.
We just have this one.
Adventure, racing, trivia, puzzle, educational. Racing's expensive for reasons. I guess because people expect good graphics for a racing
game. People accept good, people expect good graphics, and also you have to have, like, the turning physics and stuff.
I guess puzzle's good for our first one.
It's nice and cheap.
Yeah. Let's see, what kind of puzzle game do we want?
Animal puzzle.
Animal puzzle.
Robot puzzle.
Robot puzzle.
Historical puzzle.
Historical puzzle.
You know, like Luigi's Grand Adventure.
Yeah, Luigi's Grand Adventure to find the other plumber.
Yeah. Ninja. Yeah. Reversi.
That's just a puzzle game already.
Golf. And marathon.
Ooh, puzzle golf games can be fun.
Puzzle golf?
Yeah, like in real life.
Yeah. It's a B popularity, which is the highest we have access to.
So is puzzle. So if they're both equally popular.
Okay. And we can
double our budget.
Yeah, we can double our budget, which eases the burden on staff and gives us more speed and quality.
Yeah.
We can focus on research data, which means that our staff will work a little bit slower, but they'll spit out a lot of research data so we can level them up. There's quality, which means they're more likely to. You remember when that one guy caught fire? That'll happen more often.
It'll your developers are more likely to catch fire.
And then emphasize speed. Don't worry about quality, which is the normal game dev option, I think, in the AAA space.
And
Portal is like Bustle Golf if you think of yourself as the ball.
And if you think of your Portal as a hole.
Let's just go with normal because it's cheaper to do.
Alrighty.
Oh, we have direction points.
Yeah.
We have 8.
Approachability 0. Perfect.
Yeah, we have 8 axes upon which we can judge our game. Do we want a realistic puzzle golf game?
No.
Do we want a niche appeal puzzle golf game?
I mean, it's a puzzle golf game.
That's probably going to need some niche appeal.
Yeah.
We're going to need to hire Travis Touchdown.
And we don't want it to look like Tower Unite Golf, so some polish is important.
Okay.
I shouldn't say look like, because that game looks great.
We still have 5 points. Simplicity? Simplicity is good in a puzzle game.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe it's not, because then the puzzles are easy.
Well, simple doesn't mean easy.
Yeah, that's...
It might in this game.
Again, this is nebulous. This is probably what we
Approachability.
Want.
Approachability.
Cuteness?
And make it cute as shit.
Okay, we probably don't need a lot of game world. We don't need a lot of world building in our golf game.
You don't need to find lore on random helmets.
Yeah.
Golf helmets.
Let's put 1 point in realism.
All right.
Congratulations on starting your FiArst game. Who should we have write the game proposal? You can either use a scenario writer on staff or hire an outside expert. We do have a writer.
Yeah. Oh, and he's good. He's good. Look at that, 24.
He's not bad for someone we got for free.
Uh-huh.
Hey, John.
Puzzle games are my specialty. Just leave this to me. John Gameson, Video Games Marine.
Okay, well.
Not terrible.
Not overwhelming. At last, it's time to start game development. Good luck. Everyone looks excited to be working on this project.
Dev Elopment.
We've started development on our new game. The icons floating up from each staff member's computer represent game points, which are added to fun, creativity, bugs, etc., which are the icons at the bottom. Press up or down on the main screen to scroll the information bar, and tap the OK key to display detailed information. So what's the other... Oh, this is our finances.
Mm-hmm. Oh, shit!
So, you say puzzle block.
Mm-hmm.
What do you mean by that?
No, like, you know how you can have, like, a puzzle billiards game? Like that, where you...
Oh, sure, where it's just trick shots.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense.
Only with, like, mini golf courses.
Okay, so you're trying to bank off of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like watching Adam Savidan play,
Fucking, we're basically making Kirby's Dream Course.
Oh, right! Kirby's Dream Course.
Mm-hmm.
The alpha version of the current G-Aim is now finished. It's time to really start working on the graphics. Who should we put in charge of character design? So we don't have a graphics designer on staff, so we have to...
Steve Kingley.
So we have to hire comic fan Steve Kingley or comic artist Jake Kirby.
Yes, Jake Kirby.
Yep.
I mean, Jake Kirby's going to do a better job, but he also costs almost $100,000.
Yeah. We have rather a lot of money.
Mm-hmm. We gotta make sure we turn a profit still, though.
Yeah. You're not wrong. Let's just go with Steve Kingley.
It's an honor to work for you. I'm sure I can come up with some designs that are just perfect for a golf game.
A puzzle game? A golf game?
Then I should do this!
We got the double digits.
Yeah?
Well, I never actually played a lot of Kirby's Dream Course.
I've
seen it go, and it looks quite good.
I may or may not have obsessively played it as a kid until I could hole in one every course.
That seems like a lot.
I can't do it anymore. I'm fucking terrible at it now. It does not stick with you.
the beta version of the current GAME is now complete. Or GAME, I guess.
GAME.
The beta version of the current GAME is now complete. We should start paying attention to the sound now. You can either choose a sound engineer on your staff or outsource it to an outside specialist.
Fortunately, we have a robot girl.
We do fortunately have a robot girl on staff. It's finally my turn up at bat. I'll pop up with some music that will be a perfect match for a golf game. Okay.
She composing that music real good.
Hey. People are gonna remember this soundtrack.
Mm-hmm.
Robot Girl and Bat name a more iconic duo, I will wait.
Spoiler. You can't.
Apparently they broke up Billy Kay and Peyton Royce.
I don't...
They're the Iconics.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
They were clearly going to... Getting ready to do that, like, last year.
Yeah. They're gay, you understand.
Yeah. Vince didn't understand that.
No, I think someone told him.
Uh-huh.
Because they didn't just break them up. They're like, you're on different
shows now. Not just on different... Not only that, but they broke them up by having them get super interested in men.
Oh, that sucks.
Yep.
Okay, good. I didn't realize that.
Yeah, it's gross.
The game under development is now complete. Now you will start the debugging process. Each time you fix a bug, you will get research data, which you can use to level up staff. Also, on the game information screen, you have the option to ship a game without fixing all the bugs, like a real developer. I understand that game dev is complicated. And sometimes you miss stuff, and sometimes stuff gets out the door.
On the other hand, then you play a game, you know, a lot like the game that was full of bugs, and you realize, oh, this is possible.
You can just, like, you can do it if you put in, if you allow the people that work for you, who are talented and useful people, to do the job that you've presumably hired them
for. Mm-hmm.
Our company's first game is final, why complete? This game seems to have good fun. Excellent.
Good fun.
It's got good fun. It's... What are we calling it? What are we calling our puzzle golf game? Soaring Eagles. Birdie Blaster.
Dolph Denim Golf.
Okay. See, if we do this, we might get sued by, like, Tim Conway.
For Dorf?
Yeah, for Dorf. Do you have a problem with that? Are you willing to accept the Tim Conway gambit?
Absolutely.
Okay.
This shows promise. I like this kind of game. This idea isn't bad, but still needs work. Jerks.
Three fours is pretty good for a first game, honestly.
Mm-hmm.
Those aren't great scores, but maybe the players won't mind. Let's hope it sells. Wow, I've just learned that Senga is going to be announcing a new console.
Good old Senga, they are the best console manufacturer.
Let's go to the press conference right away.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Today we would like to announce our new console. The Exodus.
It's the opposite of Genesis.
If we called it the Leviticus, people would start giving us weird looks. Next one's like Numbers. That doesn't really fit. Deuteronomy.
If we called it the Leviticus, people would give us shit for wearing different materials in our pants.
Okay.
Yeah, that's one of the laws of Leviticus.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, you can't wear mixed fabric in your clothing. You're only allowed to wear one fabric at a time.
That makes sense.
I believe the punishment is being stoned to death.
Oh, that sounds right.
Yeah.
That sounds like the Old Testament.
Especially Leviticus.
Andy says, welcome, please, to this Mtembo Barat.
We will be releasing lots of fun games. Stay tuned, everyone. The initial shipment is planned to be 990,000 units.
And every single one of those will be bought by someone for some reason.
I see they've released a new console. A new console.
A new console. Man, every 4 years these game developers come out with a new console. Making me rebuy Gradius. I see you.
I see you and your Vic Vipers.
Thank you. Thank you for having the closer. After we've built up some capital, we should try getting a license. Our company's game is finally on SAL.
SAL is my favorite beer.
Thank you. Let me take a sip of this mojito. Our fans are slowly increasing around the country. We should try advertising to get our name out there.
Oh, I love our name out there. Wow, I really thought that a puzzle golf game would be more popular with girls.
Guess not.
This game also has a heavy bias towards adding male fans because of what people think video games are still.
The gamers.
Uh-huh. By the way, game dev story, everyone plays video games.
Every fucking person. So here's Dolph. It's selling
decent.
Dolph's first week sales have just come in. Sales totaled 88,788 units. Its sales ranking was, well, we didn't make it on the charts this time, but we can't let it get to us. Let's try harder next time.
She didn't insult our idea, at least.
That's true. Do we want to run, like, another contract and make some quick money, or...
I'd say start on another game.
Just go straight into a new game.
Yeah.
Do we want to try and...
pulling in money, and we're back to where we were.
Do we want to try and get a license for the brand new Exodus? Get in on the ground floor of gaming?
It's a lot of money. I'd say try and get a license for the...
Oh, for the Microsex?
For the Microsex.
Sure. Hello! Thank you for applying to develop for the Microsex. It looks like you've got enough capital. Alright, I'll give you a license and a development kit.
Oh man, I love development kits.
I hope you'll develop some games that will help promote our console. Good luck!
Combinations, you can now develop games for the Microsex.
Good. Let's do that. What kind of game do we want to make for the Microsex?
Let's see. What do we got? We could do a racing game.
We could do a racing game, although that is more...
Racing golf. Fuck trivia games. They're popular in Japan. Not very many other places, though, trivia games.
Yeah.
That's another thing, is we're probably going to see a bias as to what's popular in Japan rather than other places in the world, because it's a Japanese developer.
That's true. We can make an adventure game.
Yeah. Let's do it. That's adventure game.
Adventure!
Adventure! Paul Rubens!
Pirate adventure. Animal adventure.
If we choose pirate adventure and it says that that's not a good mix...
I'm really going to shit every pants.
Like, that should get us a compliment. Like, this is the best idea.
Yeah. Let's go with pirate adventure.
All right.
So how do we want to...
Game world high.
We need some more game world in our adventure game. That just makes sense.
Yeah. Probably don't need as much niche appeal.
Okay. We have two more points we can spend.
Could put them into cuteness as well.
We could put them back into cuteness.
Yeah.
Make a cute pirate adventure.
That's right.
A cute, well-polished pirate adventure.
That's me.
A cute, well-polished pirate adventure?
Yeah.
I agree. Okay, game number two will be a pirate adventure game. Who do you want to write the proposal? So we can have John do it again.
Yeah.
Because he's free, but he did the last one, so he's going to be a little burned out.
Yeah. Well, his power's still up there.
His power's still up there, but that's different from, like, the burnout factor.
Oh, I thought the burnout was directly represented by their stamina.
No, it's a little different. You want to hit okay just to see how this goes?
Sure.
Okay. Pirate game, I'll try to make something that's never been done before.
Adventure game, eh?
Pirate game? I just have to do this and...
Oh, there we go.
Oh, dang.
Yeah.
No, John's really excited, I guess.
Yeah.
I was wrong, I suppose.
Yeah, I could have swore it was completely represented by their power meter.
Okay. Woo, I really worked hard on that. At last, it is time to start game dev. Elfman, good luck.
Our money's still going up from the previous game, too.
Oh, yeah, that is good. Let's look at our sales are going down, but that's, you know, to be expected over the course of a unit's life.
Yeah.
We're being asked to...
Excuse me. I'd like to try increasing the creativity of our game in development. Could I have your permission to try?
It would cost $50,000 to do that.
Yeah, but Noob Ownerton wants to step up to bat and own some noobs!
That's true. So, this is a gamble. You can see the success up there at the top right.
Ooh, that is quite low.
We can make it bigger by spending more research data.
Yeah.
But we only have 29 research data, so it bumps up to 38.
Mm-hmm. Hmm.
So the consequences of us losing this is we suddenly get a lot of bugs in our game.
Yeah. This seems like it may not be worth the risk.
We could just say no.
Yeah.
Nah, we need to play it safe right now. Yeah, I know, Noob. We need to play it safe right now. Listen, I'm sorry. You're sorry. Let's make a night of it.
I'm sorry. You're sorry. Let's not do this.
Thank you. The alpha version of the current game. I'm not going to read those every time. We still don't have a graphics person, so... We can have Steve do it again.
Or we could
step up.
We could step it up with a good old not Jack Kirby.
Good old not Jack Kirby. We do have money, and we are still making money.
Yeah. It's an honor to work for you. I'm S.U.R. I can come up with designs that are just perfect for a pirate game. A pirate game?
Wow, Jake's really into pirates.
A talking cat.
He can only talk once. I saw the trailer for that. I have no interest in watching the thing.
Just watch
the trailer's mystifying.
Just watch Allison Pregler's video on it. It's better than the movie.
Neon Exodus Game Evangelion.
Congratulations, Shinji.
Congratulations.
This is not intended to be condescending or hateful.
But it sounds that way because that's what you've internalized, I think. I don't...
No, it's literally not intended to sound that way, like, by the writers. It sounds...
Someone should have told the actors, maybe?
It sounds that way in English and Japanese.
Oh, okay.
That's the thing. It sounds awful because it's a really badly written show.
Yeah. The latest issue of Gamgai magazine has arrived.
Gamagui.
Thank you. The recently released Exodus H has proven to be quite popular, reaching 1 million units sold in a very short period of time. But consoles must continue to sell in order to be considered a success. In many cases, a hit game prompts people to purchase a system. Indeed, a single hit game can greatly change a console's fortunes.
Good.
It's asking us for a challenge.
Yep.
The beta version of the game's done. Should we let Callie do it since Callie has more power?
Callie's not running low on energy.
Yeah.
Not bad.
It's going. One more? No. So it is... Alright, I forgot to ask what this game's about. Excuse me, I'd like to try increasing... No, wait, California. Excuse me, I'd like to try increasing the creativity of our game and development. Could I have your permission to try? Cost money, we can get it up to not a coin flip.
Mm-hmm.
So, probably not, Callie. Sit back down. Oh, I like how sad that they are, that they weren't able to, like...
Mm-hmm.
I thought I had a cool idea.
Alright, so it's a pirate adventure.
It's pirate adventure.
Alright. So, it's about
about Edward Carnby.
That's what from
only
from,
he's from, only he's pirates this time.
From Alone in the Dark.
Yeah, like Alone in the Dark 2, which is a pirate one.
I thought that was the Cowboys one.
That's 3.
Okay. Alone in the Dark. It's a series of alternate dimensions.
Edward Carnby just keeps fucking it up, is the thing.
Mm-hmm. It's still wild to me that the Wii version of the... which is generally considered the worst version of the Alone in the Dark reboot, is the best version of the Alone in the Dark reboot.
That is a real shame, and I don't know what the fuck is with it.
Mm-hmm.
Our company's game number 2 is finally complete. It seems to have good fun.
It leaves out all the worst parts, is the thing.
What is it called?
Together in the Light.
Buckle. I think that might be too long. Together in...
Oh, there's enough space with spaces.
Oh, I didn't realize I wasn't spacing.
Yeah.
I spaced on that, as a matter of fact.
Lol.
Right? I thought it was funny. In...
I gotta adjust to Nintendo prompts.
Yeah. The space
capital.
Thank you, capital L.
Let me put another letter on there.
Okay. There we go. Did have to put the G in, but we got there, everybody. We're together in the light. Ship it.
It's for hardcore gamers, oh no. This is pretty good. Title screen wasn't bad. I got really hooked.
That's a market improvement.
Uh-huh. That's a pretty good.
It looks like it could have used a bit more work, but it may sell well, depending on how we promote it. Alright, we haven't done advertising at all.
That's Emory. Oh yeah, do some advertising.
Let's have a look at some advertising just before our game comes out. It's a sneak preview. Gamers love that, I think.
Sneak preview.
Advertising. Magazine ads, online ads.
Oh, let's give them pop-up windows. Everyone likes that.
Everyone loves pop-up windows. You used online ads. Truck Entertainment's fame is now increased.
Hooray! Apparently girls like online ads somewhat. Chicks dig giant robots.
Chicks dig giant robots. That kicked us immediately to the black.
Mm-hmm.
Not by, like, a lot, but... Hey, we made the top 20.
All right.
We're number 20 in the top 20, but...
That's not bad for our second game.
Yeah. Try using some advertising.
We just did that.
Fuck a bike, secretary. Do we want to just... jam on?
Yeah.
Alright. Next game. Actually, let's train some people real quick.
Good idea.
Because we're running out of stuff we can do. Let's go to our staff and go to train. Who do we want to train on stuff?
Ooh, let's see. Does everyone have full power?
Everyone does have full power.
Okay, that's good.
We could, so, who is, like, lowest on what they do? I guess it's Noob. So let's train Noob. And you can see at the right what this is going to do. This would bring up Noob's scenario and graphics a little bit. Reading would bring up coding and scenario writing.
Game.
Go play a game. Go play other games and see what they're doing.
It'll make you better at game.
Playing game makes you better at game. The truth come out. RAM numbers increased.
Hooray.
Oh, that was good. I was hoping we'd unlock a new thing. The fiscal year just ended. Normally, you'd have to pay your staff salary at this point. However, this year, the government is going to pay to encourage development of the game industry.
You can tell this isn't America.
You know, just in case you fucked up real bad in your first year because you didn't understand some of the core conceits and you're deeply into the red, we're going to figure that out for you.
Mm-hmm.
You have a whole nother year to work it, so you'll have to pay starting next year, so make sure you have enough cash available. I just make a new thing, then.
All right.
For the Microx. What do we want to do? We could make a racing.
We could. Let's do it.
All right.
Who's going to be racing? Ninjas?
Ninja racing does sound fun.
Uh-huh.
I think that's one of those things where it'll go, I don't know about all that, but...
Animal racing? It works great for that, goddammit, the zoo race.
Yeah, the zoo race.
I was thinking Super Noah's Ark 3D, but no, that's an older shooter.
Race me, Hannah. Race me around the yard. Wow, I wish the government would pay my business's first year of expenses, right?
I wish the government would pay for our whole grocery bill. Fuck.
I wish the government would pay people to exist comfortably.
Mm-hmm.
Also, Land Before Time racing for historical.
Mm-hmm.
I like the idea of a historical racing game.
Hell yeah.
Where, like, I'm trying to think of some historical figures that aren't shitty, and it turns out that history is written by the shitty.
Uh-huh.
So not a lot are coming to me off the top of my head.
It's like how in Romania...
Oh, like Ben-Hur, that makes more sense.
It's like how in Romania, Vlad Tepes is generally seen as a hero, but everywhere else in the world, he's known as some guy who dropped people on spikes, which there's not actually historical proof of, just things written by Germany.
Sure. He did burn his own people's crops?
No, he burned the crops as the Germans were taking over.
Oh, okay.
So that the Germans could not then use the land against them.
All right, that makes more sense.
Uh-huh.
I like robot racing also.
That would be good, robot racing.
Let's race with robots.
Everybody super robot racing.
So what do we need?
Dump it all into cuteness.
Dump it all into cuteness, you're saying.
Yeah.
All into cuteness.
Realism should be down to nothing. Everything should go in cuteness and polish.
I got bad news for you. We only have two left after maxing out our cuteness.
The cutest robot race.
I think this is a space where we want to put some in innovation. Because this is robots, not cars. That means they can do wild shit.
Like Excitebots.
Like Excitebot, sure.
Which is the sequel to Excitetruck.
Which is the sequel to Excitebike.
Yes.
What was the one with the unicyclers?
That was Uniracers.
Oh, right. Yeah. What was the one with the balls that had lizard faces on them?
That was Iggy's Wrecking Balls.
Ah, yes, Iggy's Wrecking Balls. Thank you very much.
It's weird that I know all this stuff just off the top of my head.
Okay, game number three will be a Robot Racing game. King? Sing.
Robot Racing game.
Who do you want to write the proposal? Let's have John do it again.
Yeah, he's good at it.
Okay, here it is.
I'm not sure I can give this one my best.
Yeah, I think we just let him like rest more between that.
Yeah, rest every couple of scenarios.
Hey, that soft demon dog is here.
Hey, what's up, soft demon dog?
Hey, Xenon. It's a robot game.
John Gameson from video games, that's right.
Okay, you were talking some smack, John, but He's putting
himself out there for us. That means we definitely got to give him the rest next time.
At last, it's time to start game dev.
Oh, shit!
Just immediately off the bat.
Mm-hmm.
So, hey, tell us how this sound is, by the way. We can fix some of this. You're letting your employees rest? What kind of game company are you? The kind that aren't monsters?
This is a good, happy video game studio or an extremely horrible video. This has been a happy video game studio so far.
Okay, so...
We have completely avoided crunch somehow.
Okay, so Anne, though, is having a breakthrough on bugs. And is just dumping a lot of bugs into our system.
Oh, no.
So that's something that's happening.
Oh, no, she's malfunctioning.
Yeah. Did you want to... Because you did noobs at least last time.
Excuse me.
I'd like to try increasing the sound of our game in development.
What can we do? 25%. Sound isn't really what you do, noob.
Give it a shot, but we'd have to give up, to have even a decent chance, we'd have to give up all of our research. I'd say no on this one.
Yeah.
Oh.
We need the players to have a sound blaster card.
The alpha oh, that's the secretary.
I'm not going to read these anymore, these dialogue windows, because they're all the same, but they do show them to you every time.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we have a new...
This is the fictional character now.
It's Quinn Harley.
She costs too much.
How much? She costs, like, the remainder of our budget.
Probably Jake is good again.
Jake did it last time.
Uh-huh.
It's an honor to work for you. I'm sure I said such.
Yeah. Sorry, that's... I don't want to stick it to this too much. Oh, Jake.
Wow, Jake.
You phoned it in, Jake. You fucked us.
You're fucking with me? You're fucking with me?
Oh, good. It's good that we didn't spend all of our money.
Mm-hmm.
Because here comes...
Hello, I'm a representative of Item S and Things.
Wait, why isn't it Peter Pumpkin?
This what?
Yeah, he's got the same shape as Peter Pumpkin. He's even got the pumpkin hair.
Okay.
But he's not Peter Pumpkin, the usual Kairosoft salesman.
It might be that just, you know...
Pumpkin not been invented yet at this point?
Maybe not. This is one of their earlier games.
Mm-hmm.
The items we sell are very useful, and they are priced accordingly.
They're priced usefully.
Boost items require research data to use, but can be used any number of times.
Fun boost, creativity boost, graphic boost, and sound boost. Those are all good. We want this one.
Yes.
The career change manual, thank you.
That way Callie can become a graphic designer.
Yeah, and we can start... doing that.
Any of the boost items, we can wait till next time.
Yeah, because again, that would take the rest of our budget.
Yeah. Ice cream bars. All right.
Yeah, that just sounds good.
Oh, this is Peter not squash. Gotcha.
Oh. Shitty brother to Peter Pumpkin.
Yeah. Yeah. Gamagooey.
Gamagooey Magazine has arrived.
I'm having trouble saying it now.
We here at Gamagooey Magazine have recently succeeded in interviewing a famous game developer, who we are not going to name. According to him, the best way to increase the number of game types you have is to train your employees. Your employees' job types and levels also affect the types of games they can discover. From what we understand, scenario writers are particularly good at discovering new game types, so you may want to try training yours.
The developer they talked to was Wario, wasn't it?
Aha! Just stick them in a fucking room and slap them with books until they learn new stuff.
Books are for learning. Throwing books!
Good. I'm glad we did that.
Me too.
I'm glad we did that together.
Me too. Beta.
Beta's done, so now we... Oh, I forgot to do the fucking thing.
Muzak.
Hey, Annie. It's okay. I know you can make a good robot game soundtrack. It's in your blood. Your robot blood.
Blood? I hope this is not...
Robot
blood. Okay. They're just not pulling out the stops on this one.
Yeah, that was partly because she had, like, no energy left.
Uh-huh.
But we'd done Callie last time, and Callie hadn't. Yeah. Oh, let me use that thing while I'm thinking about it. It's in here. Use item.
Deadpool.
Career change manual.
Callie.
California.
And not be changed to graphic designer. Yeah. Oh, wait, I guess designer is graphic designer.
Yeah, yeah.
Of course.
Of course!
Ha 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 ha! I'm Bison Wario.
I will do my best from now on as a designer. Game under development is complete. We're going to debug it still.
Well, we had 69 for just an eighth of a second.
Nice. Nice. I think that in our robot game, we should all, like, be on our hands, the robots.
Oh, like Excitebots.
Like Excitebots, yeah.
We've just created Excitebots.
We've done Excitebots again, is the thing. It worked the first time.
We should just call it, not Excitebots.
Okay. Sounds good. Oops. Too many. Too many backups. Not. Is it with an E or does it start with an X?
Excitebots.
Okay. Excitebots.
Enthusebots. What are you looking for?
I'm looking for the TM, but it doesn't have it.
Oh, no.
Not Excitebots. Shipping. Don't worry about it. Nintendo doesn't even exist.
Close, try harder. Good idea, I enjoyed it. Still needs work. Too short!
I mean, that's good, right? You leave them wanting more. You leave them wanting more of the exciting robots.
That's how they're selling Doom Eternal's ending.
God damn it, I'm so mad. This isn't one where the name of your game can't be changed later, is it? No. You just do it and then it goes. Not everybody listens to the critics. Don't worry about it. Sitebots is on sale. It's going. Oh, we should have advertised.
Yeah.
It is number 18. We're climbing that ladder.
Hell yeah.
We're gonna make ourselves famous.
Here, toss out some ads now.
Oh, that's a good idea. Action. Advertisement. Nope. I said action. Advertisements. Do we want to send the demo out there? That's a lot of money.
Yeah, go with the online ads or the magazine ads for now.
Go with the magazine ads.
Oh, there we go. Apparently girls read magazines.
Yeah, when they're having their hair dried in one of those massive dome dryers.
We're learning so much about girls today, aren't we?
Yeah. I didn't know anything about girls. That's why I had to become one, so that I could see how they think. You got a fan letter.
Ooh, from Bobby Anderson 15. Hello, I'm a high school student and I love truck entertainment games. In fact, I've been playing them so much, I failed my last math test. I'm really looking forward to what you're going to put out in the future, so please work hard on them. By the way, my favorite game is, not Excitebots. Wow, he doesn't like Excitebots, huh?
Our entertainment, no, Excitebots is for dunks. That's why we made our better one. What happened to the first 14 Bobbies Anderson? That's a good question. No more questions. Our fan base, excuse me. Truck Entertainment's fan base, the country is growing. It's not better. You can't get me a jury and show me how you begin a word with HRO.
It's pronounced fish.
We picked up 9 more fans in the 13 to 18 demographic.
All right.
But better still, 420 growth.
Nice.
Let's let everybody chill for a bit.
Yeah.
Let them chill, ref.
Train up Kelly's.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Graphic design.
Let's go to train.
People are going to have to trade off on this next project, though.
Drops of Jupiter. Yeah, I agree. So...
There's nothing that gives her plus on graphics, huh?
No, we haven't unlocked enough stuff. Scroll and movie are the two things.
Movie's probably the better bet, since she'll probably be doing sound again.
Oh, that would make sense.
Ba 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 ba.
Art type unlocked.
Nice.
We can now make an art game.
Hell yeah.
You know, an art game? A game that's a specific type of game that is art. You know,
Mario Paint?
Yeah, like Mario Paint. Oh, I guess that's what it is.
Yeah.
or like Passepartout, right?
Yeah.
But the way that people talk about stuff, it immediately, every single time I've played this game before, it made me go, oh, right, an art game, you know, like Ico or The Witness or, you know, something high-minded that probably has a shitty person at the helm.
Shadow of the Colossus, the game that wouldn't run until it was remastered, like, 10 years later.
It ran, just not well.
It ran at, like, 6 frames per second. It was completely unplayable for me.
Yeah. Let's dev. Actually, should we do a contract real quick, since we're gonna have to hire out a lot of people?
Sure.
Let's just make some money real quick. Nope, not that. Contract.
Town mascots, fuck yes.
Yeah.
Why does that require programming?
You know, to make sure that the mascots don't go haywire in Five Nights at Freddy's, everybody.
Gotcha. They're not people in costumes, they're robots.
I'd like to try increasing that. No, we're not going to give you a fun boost because we only need 5 fun. Not programming.
His name is Noob Ownerton, which means he's not good at fun.
Yeah, that is true. Yeah, an art game like Mario Paint or those college student movies. Eraserhead?
Or like Grindhouse.
We don't have any more than 3 fun. It's for a little entertainment. In this economy, it is unscrupulous to have more fun. All right, that's money. Let's go ahead and make a thing. What do we want to make? Do we want to make an art game?
Level people up real quick first. We've got 100+.
We do have 100+. Let's go ahead. Level up everyone.
Yeah.
Just give everyone a round.
Yeah, sounds good.
Because it's 15 for each. That'll even leave us with some left over.
Yeah.
Okay.
Level 2 Coda, that's a big boost too.
Yeah.
The big boost. It does increase their salaries, but that's okay. Yeah.
Oh, that's a massive boost.
Oh, yeah. Ow. Could have been worse.
Could have been worse. Could have been better.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was median.
All right, there we go.
Let's develop, or actually, I want to send our scenario writer off to train or something.
Okay.
So that we can try and unlock something else. What works for scenarios? It's basically just reading.
Or writing, yeah.
Anime. We can make them, like, sit down and watch Keep Your Hands Off Aizuken or something.
Good. Sounds good to me.
I fucked up.
Samurai type unlock.
Okay, well.
Does anime.
No, I accidentally hit movie.
Oh, okay. Well, that's fine.
Yeah. That's fine.
You did unlock samurai and movies.
Yeah, let's wait for our last person to come back. Because they'll come back fully charged. And then we'll start it up. You gotta start.
Yeah, my name's Noob.
I'm 47 and I learned how to fucking read.
First name Noob, last name Cybot.
God damn it, Noob. We can make any of these things.
Yeah.
What's over here in type? Samurai is new and open to us, and an A popularity.
Ooh, movies is also A popularity.
Yeah.
More expensive.
Art games B, which is not as low as I thought it would be.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to make a samurai game.
Sure. And make Neo.
An adventure samurai game? The last game we did was racing, so it wouldn't, like...
Yeah, we could level up adventure. I believe that doing it twice is what it takes to get to level 2.
That would make sense.
What's under direction that you can do?
Normal, speed, quality, research, and budget. If we're gonna do any of these, I would want to do budget because it actually kicks the shit out of the out of anything else. But it would make the game cost
double. Yeah.
Yeah, $540 to make.
Well, I say we give it a shot. Let's take that. Let's take that dive.
Big swings. How do we want it? All cuteness.
Let's go with some realism.
Okay.
Samurai.
Samurai are a real thing. Yeah. That's true.
Samurai existed.
Samurai existed. So maybe game we world, put some big game time. World in there.
Want some simplicity, or yeah, we want a little simplicity and some approachability. We don't want this to be
one in both.
Yeah. This looks good to me.
Okay. A samurai adventure game. Genre the last one. Do we need to tag out?
Yeah, we're gonna have
Josh Slackerville or Mark Jersey or Sid Hightower.
Mark Jersey is 100k. That seems doable.
Yeah, we're probably gonna have to like hire a we have an in-house artist.
Yeah,
but we're probably gonna have to get a new sound engineer.
Yeah,
so we're gonna have to pay for that too.
I think we can probably get one for 100k though, and we'd still be able to afford that.
Okay.
Understood. A adventure game.
Every time I hear this, I think do 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 do.
You mean the backwards long jump?
I mean, kind of, but it's I want to say Mario Land 2. Do 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 do.
Are you talking about the Toad House?
Oh yeah, it's Mario Brothers 3.
Yeah, yeah.
You're right. I was thinking it was Mario 2's bonus round, but that's incorrect.
So there's going to be
Land 2's bonus round.
No giant enemy crab because we put realism in our samurai game. Listen, there can still be giant crabs.
Hey, that game was very realistic and based on real historical battles.
Real historical battles. Here's this giant enemy crab.
Hey, look, we got a...
The game's direction and genre match.
We got a genre match. Adventure has increased to level 2. Also discovered some new tricks, giving us an additional 2 points to allocate to the game's direction. Ooh!
We have so How do many we do more that? Resources, huh?
How do we do that? And we can't do it till the next game?
Yeah.
Okay.
But our next game, we'll have an extra 2 points in our pool to split to between, cuteness. Like, realism or cuteness. Yeah, to add to cuteness. Those just live in cuteness now. Everything we make is very slightly cute. It's our calling card.
Yeah. Excuse me. Ooh, creativity for Callie.
What does that look like for you?
Better. That's a better start. But we still can't bump it up too high.
We can make it a coin flip at like 36.
Yeah. Want to go for it? Haven't done it yet. Might as well.
Sure. See how it goes. Big swings.
Aww.
Okay, sometimes you take the big swing.
Swing and a miss.
Yeah, and it doesn't go.
Ouch.
Well,
I'm not a bad person. I'm just not skilled enough. Sorry.
You're not. No, we know you're not a bad person.
Oh, no.
Oh, and they're having a bug breakthrough.
Oh, no. John Gamerson.
Okay, John. Hey, John. I need you to quit this bad idea you're doing, buddy.
Now we gotta start working on the good graphics. Who should we put in charge of graphics?
Our newly...
Can Callie do it?
Yeah.
Let's do it. Samurai game. That sounds interesting.
Also, that shit hit. A samurai adventure game. Okay, Callie. We got this... art easel installed for you.
So you can turn the art on and off.
But we needed it on right there. And you didn't for us.
But she is going wild on that music.
We stopped you, Callie, from being a musician.
Apparently it's still her passion.
Okay. You will have to pay your staff's salaries at the end of March.
Yes.
You should make sure you have enough money available. I got a level with you. I think that might not happen.
Nah, we'll get there.
It'll give us a grant the first time we run out of money.
Yeah. The beta version, as they say in Europe.
Yeah. So we could actually get Callie to do the sound also.
Yeah, and give that a try. She may be exhausted from just doing something.
And she apparently seems too keen on it. I was just composing some music. That would be perfect for a samurai game.
Oh, good. She was literally already doing it.
That's why she just had that breakthrough.
Yeah.
So this is going to have one of the most pumping soundtracks of all time.
Mm-hmm.
OC remixers are going to be eating off this for the next 20 years. Mm-hmm.
This is going to be a Final Fantasy VI all over again.
Yeah. Like ambient aquatic. Okay, well, there's some...
some graphics.
There's some graphics.
I said good graphics. Good. Well done. Nintendo.
I've just learned that Nintendo is going to be announcing a new console.
Would like to announce that, yes,
the IES, Nintendo Entertainment System.
Pronounced, yes.
This is what music composition looks like. When I make music, it looks like that.
Me too. I literally catch on fire. We lose more houses that way.
They're going to ship
100,000 units.
They're going to ship a lot of DOS E. It looks like they're really trying to dominate the market. We should try to get in on the action, too.
This is just following real life.
Yeah, I don't see the Nintendo taking off, to be honest with you.
Let's slowly debug
all of these bugs.
Gamagooey. With the release of the new Youth from Nintendo, there are now 4 game consoles on the market. Recent studies have shown that video games are the most wanted item among children, and many companies are working to enter the market. The game market is about to become a lot more crowded.
Well, I'd love to get my hands on one of those Nintendos.
Nicely done.
Good, I'm glad you're satisfied with your work and are going home for the day. Please take care of yourself.
Morning! They all keep completely different schedules, and that's great.
Yeah. We're a very free-flow office.
Yeah, just come and go when you want. Just get your work done.
Yep.
Bye!
Almost!
See ya!
Just need one more squashed bug, and we can ship. One more, come the fuck on.
Complete! Mission complete!
This game seems to have good sound. Which it super does.
It's got like this fucking breakbeat soundtrack whenever a fight starts.
Oh, that's boss as hell. In like 1986 or whatever, whenever the IES was released.
Mm-hmm. And it just goes...
It's shocking we could get that out of the sound chip, but that's why we have all the people we have.
That's right.
What do we want to call our samurai adventure game? Shogun Showdown.
Oh, that's probably already a thing.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, there's Samurai Showdown.
Shogun Showfun.
Shogun Chauffeur. No, that'd have to be a racing game.
I like the name Shogun Chauffeur so much. I want that to be a really bad comedy anime.
It'd be the sequel to The Devil is a Part-Timer.
Sure.
Nobunaga travels through time to the future and has to become a chauffeur to survive in the modern world.
There's a show sort of like that that's airing right now, except he's a Shiba Inu.
Yes, I've seen that.
Noba Cinnamon Nobunaga, I think it's called.
Uh-huh.
Batterit says Sam R.I.
That's good. That's good. I like that. It's the prequel to Green Eggs and Ham. Oh. Why are they dancing around?
I fucked that up.
Dogs, why are y'all dancing around?
Space. R space. Capital I.
All right.
Ship it!
Look forward to a sequel. I need more practice. Ouch. Ooh. Oh, dear. It's not for reviewers. It's not for...
No, it's not for them. It's for people who love sick-ass breakbeats.
That's right.
I'm sorry. Do you not love sick-ass breakbeats while doing sword fighting? Because if you don't, then get the fuck out of my shop.
Those aren't great scores. Better put out some ads.
Oh, yes, thank you. Advertising.
Just go with the demo. We do not have enough money. Actually, we'll get a grant if we do it and go under.
No, radio ads.
Okay.
Because that builds
in. Oh, yes.
Yeah, we can play the sick-ass breakbeats.
Yes, perfect.
Yes, good. I don't think it works that way.
No, but it makes just get a huge breakthrough with women 25 to 40.
Oh, hey. It turns out girls also like video games.
Mm-hmm.
And listen to the radio.
See, this isn't... If it's gonna be like girls like games more as time goes on, then this is incorrect.
Right.
Because girls loved games during the 80s and early 90s before boys started trying to push girls out of the hobby. And then there was this period where girls would kind of hide that they liked video games.
Yeah, otherwise they would be made fun of.
Mm-hmm.
Or just hassled generally.
Mm-hmm.
It is now the end of the fiscal year. Oh, good. $129,600 has been deducted from your funds to pay for your staff salaries. I'm glad we got this game out the door before then.
Mm-hmm.
MRI's first week sales have just come in. Sales totaled 40,000 units. Its sales ranking was number 10.
Woo!
We made it into the top 10. That should get us some attention and boost our sales.
All right.
Everyone's talking about these sick-ass breakbeats.
Do we get to see the Metacritic score after the game comes out?
So we are at number 10. There's a thing for this. Products? Yeah. We can see our games that we've made.
Mm-hmm.
And
this is only week 2 and we're starting to catch up to our previous record.
Yeah. So that's going up. The radio advertisements you purchased have seem to have been popular. Our fan base has increased slightly overall.
All right. Wow, with everyone.
Yeah.
And of course the radio ads are popular. They have sick-ass breakbeats to start them off.
All right.
MRI has sold over 10K units. Congratulations.
And by that, they mean over 100K units.
What?
Yeah, it said 10K units, but it means 100K.
Oh, right. It did say 10K. It did say 10K?
Yep.
I didn't say it wrong?
No, it said 10K.
Oh, good. Hi, salesman.
Hi, not Peter Pumpkin.
I'm a traveling salesman. May I interest you in some items?
No. I don't need any of these items right now. Oh, no, we don't have enough, I don't think. I think we need to release a new thing.
Okay.
So, what do we want to do?
Pump out a contract real quick.
Okay.
See if we can do one real quick.
Nope, that's not it. Hang on, one of these buttons works.
Develop.
Thank you, contract. We can make a pinball movie.
Oh, yes.
That's a lot of money.
Mm-hmm, I say we go for it.
All right.
We'll call it Pinball Movie.
Pinball the Movie.
Excuse me.
Oh, hi, noob.
I'd like to try increasing the sound for our pinball movie jorb.
That's not really what you do, noob. You got a 3 there.
Yeah, that's not gonna happen.
Yeah. I feel like no, noob.
Alright.
There we go. That's some stuff moving.
He's on fire!
So I always considered that this was like the marquee.
Mm-hmm.
Right? The marquee graphics for the pinball. Where like it shows where you press the trigger flipper and it shows the smart bomb going up through the Velociraptor.
Yes.
So you get that reference and I understand that. Oh, Xenon did say Metacritic, which is good. I didn't notice that, and I'm sorry for not noticing that. push led everyone.
All right, she got zero research points.
Oh, out of that breakthrough? Oh, that's good.
I love
when everyone's working hard.
The Joby.
Just what I will be expect from Truck Entertainment.
All right, now we can really make some progress.
All right, we got over $1,000. Let's shit something out.
We have over $1,000,000.
We have over $1,000,000. I keep forgetting the K is there. Let's shit something out.
Oh, let's try something totally new.
Totally new.
Let's get experimental.
A tabletop game.
Ooh.
About
art.
Art. So it's Dixit then.
It's a Spirograph. We're releasing a Spirograph.
Movies, Ninja, Reverse Eye, Golf, Marathon. Like, we could release a table reversey game.
Yeah, that's a safe one.
That's though. So boring. Let's do something cool.
Could release a movie trivia game. Also boring.
Movie trivia game is also boring.
How about just a ninja something?
Sure. Ninja tabletop game? Ninja trivia game.
Oh, what? We've only got the one page, huh?
Yeah, we do. We need to train some people if we want to get some more genres.
I don't know. I kind of like the idea of ninja racing. Still.
Ninja adventure racing! Big budget!
Hell yeah. Hype man.
Cuteness.
Once again, drop realism for a racing game.
Oh, that makes sense.
Especially if we're going to go with ninja racing. Like, if we were doing a sim racing game, absolutely, but this is ninja racing.
Yeah.
Let's bump up the polish a bit.
Okay.
Game world can probably go down a little.
Sure.
Racing games, can benefit from a story, but maybe not a big story.
Yeah. A little bit of a game world to show why these ninjas are racing.
Mm-hmm. Innovation. Let's innovate.
I think it's really innovating how this is a game company that makes and sells games. You're not wrong.
Did you spend the last 2 points?
Yeah, I spent them.
Okay. What did you spend them on?
I put them back in innovation.
Okay.
Because I thought that's what you said.
Yeah, I literally blinked and you were done.
Oh. Game 5 will be a ninja racing game. We just let John do it.
Yeah, should be fine now.
I just came up with a great idea for a ninja racing game.
Alright.
Yeah, like, we don't do season passes or anything. This, John.
It's a start.
See, this is what we were talking about.
Yeah.
That's a bit of an odd combination. I'm sure you can pull it off, but...
Fucking,
They're not too happy about working on ninja racing.
It turns out it's just a Sekiro mod. Where you just fucking... Because that man runs super fast.
Sekiro racing mod.
Wolf just runs so fucking fast. You could totally make a racing game out of that.
I'd like to try increasing the creativity of our game in development. How's that going?
Ooh, not bad.
We can get you up to 80.
Yeah, and that's as high as you're allowed to go. Go for it.
Sure. Big swings.
Success! All right.
Oh, yeah, that's doing that.
Oh, that's some big success.
Yeah. Good, because we needed something.
Uh-huh.
Look at how much that increased our hype, also.
Uh-huh.
People heard about, they're trying something new and weird over there.
Uh-huh. Ooh, we just got a bunch of research points, too.
Oh, good.
We got 4 off of Noob as well. Oh, here.
So it is just a Sekiro mod, you're saying?
The game's direction and genre match. Because direction is budget, which matches everything.
Yeah.
Hey there, Two Flower.
Hey there. Thank you for coming back. This is, they re-released Did Kairosoft Game Dev Story for Switch, so we're fucking around with that.
Mm-hmm.
We're making a Sekiro racing mod.
Yeah.
Who should we put in charge of character design? Callie looks like she's sort of spent.
She's got enough to do it. Did she do the last one, though?
She did do the last one. That's what the prev means.
Okay.
So we could get Steve or Jake or Quinn to do it.
I mean, we could go with Quinn.
We could go with Quinn.
That might help because we are, I don't know, it's a risk to take someone that expensive.
It is, but A, we have the money, and B, again, we need something.
Yeah.
So let's see how that goes. Sekiro card, thank you. That is the correct way to do that.
You can only play as Wolf, and it sounds bad, except then you find out that you really like Wolf. You know, the thing Dark Souls was best at was creating a world around your own character, so it seems kind of weird that Wolf is actually likable enough to carry the game.
Wolf is such a good character.
He's the himbo we deserve.
Okay.
He's a himbo samurai.
I'm not gonna argue with you.
Every time someone asks if he understands something,
he's
just goes,
like, no.
No.
I don't. What do you mean, cooked? I've just been eating this plain, unboiled rice.
He did, too. The fucking divine child is like, you know, it's better if you cook it first. And he's like, cook it.
Cook rice?
He's actually confused by the concept of cooking rice, and it's beautiful.
Yeah. Draw a sword and running in the 90s starts blaring. No, that was our last game, which was a samurai adventure game with rad-ass breakbeats. It was our breakout hit.
Yep. The critics didn't like it, but it was a huge success with players.
Yeah. Because everyone loves sick-ass breakbeats.
That's right. Ooh, we just got a big sound boost there.
We did. We haven't even worked on it right now, and it's up to 12.
Yeah. Callie is good at that music, even if it's not her job anymore.
Our hype is 30. Oh, yeah. Right, we got some hype because we got, like, a well-known comic artist to work on it.
Yeah.
Like
Clerks 2, it's not for critics.
So Clerks 2 wasn't for critics. Like, it was for fans of Clerks.
Yep.
And it was gonna do well off the back of that.
Yep.
And that's fucking it. And that's fine.
Mm-hmm. It's
just that when you come, like, aggressive about it,
you sound like a giant.
You do sound like a giant douchebag, yeah. Anne wants to try and increase the sound of the game and develop.
I mean, yeah.
Very good at that.
We can hit 71.
We can spend literally the rest of our.
I say go for it. We'll get more from bug fixing.
Big swings!
Yes! Yosh! Yosh! Eggman! I'm Eggman! I adore these little squidgy.
Holy shit.
Oh, wow, that was... Okay, well...
We just went from zero to some genre of music that rhymes with zero.
We went from zero to Witch House. the beta version, and this is where we actually work on the music. So this is going to be...
We can also up our hype with advertising here.
We can a little bit. We should start paying attention to the sound now.
Oh, it's all ska, yes.
All ska?
And traditional ska, not American ska.
48 trumpets. That would be all ska.
I guess it is trumpets, so I guess it's got to have American ska.
So let's just have Anne do it, because... That's all.
She's exhausted.
She is exhausted, but we're up. We're 50 up.
All right, toss in some ads.
I think I want to wait until like.
It's if you do it ahead of time, it's then we get the second bonus soon.
Okay. Advertisements. We can do more radio.
Does have high sound. We can just barely afford that. We can go for it.
Yeah,
that's
sure.
That's our last expense.
Let's hope we don't fucking lose all of our money on this deal. We're getting a little low on cap at all. It looks like we're going to have to dip into our emergency fund of 150K. If we run out of money while developing a game, we may have to cancel the project. This is all the money we have, so if you find yourself running low, select develop and contract to get a job. Listen, I've had enough of your sass.
Alright, we did it. We done it.
We've not done it yet. We need to quash the bugs. We're in Operation Bug Hunter, whatever the fuck Hi-Rez called it.
Operation we'll never ever actually fix the game breaking bug.
Operation Jesus Christ, we're trying, but we don't have enough resources. Please send help.
Operation Hi-Rez claims that we're doing everything we can, but really we're not giving Evil Mojo any money or manpower.
Yeah. I've just learned that Nintendo is going to be announcing another new console.
Wow, I guess we missed out. Didn't have enough Nintendos. Okay. We're up to the GameKid.
Yeah, it's handhelds now.
Yeah.
Ooh, we're releasing lots of fun games. Stay tuned. That is a lot of units.
The quest for the game child.
This is the first portable game console. I bet it'll be especially popular with younger players. You just told me this is a very valuable object. Which means it means nothing to me.
You've forgotten one thing. Things of value have no value. No, things of worth have no value to me.
Drops down the stairwell.
Explodes for some reason.
For some reason.
It was a nuclear armament device.
Or something, but that doesn't mean there's explosions in it. Maybe there was explosions packed into it to help it not get into Russian hands or something.
It came with free explosions.
Free explosions.
Yeah, that was part of the ad campaign.
Damn. The 80s was a nightmare, huh? do we just want to call this Sekiro Kart? Or do we want to come up with something else?
We should call it Wolf's Run.
I like Wolf's Run. Oh, and that means our big sound means that we got Mr. Big to do the soundtrack. That's a joke about an anime.
Yep.
I've been watching anime again, and it's really a shame.
Lost the thread of the conversation.
Yeah.
I suggest you look up Ashens and the Quest for the Game Child.
It's a film that's...
And also... Ashens and the Polybius Heist.
Polybius Heist.
Which is a much better movie.
It's a much better movie. but Ashens is a YouTube person who reviews, cheap garbage that he got from the British equivalent of a Dollar Tree, which is called Poundland. And
the 99p stores, which no longer exist.
Yep. And other stuff, but mostly that.
Yep.
And he also made 2 movies.
And he's been in several more.
It's
probably why Polybius Heist was the first suggestion when I typed Ashens, yeah.
Yeah.
It's also, new. It's only a couple months out.
Oh, I already did this bit. No. Don't back up. I got to talking about a thing. Ship it!
Oh no, we really don't make games for critics.
We really don't.
Ah, except for... Wait a second.
That's Pumpkin Man.
You gave us a poor review because we didn't buy your shit.
Those aren't great scores, but maybe players won't mind. I guarantee you they will not. Oh, look at that. What's that? What's that, 20,000 units first week?
Holy shit.
Number 25. Okay, that's actually not as good as we've done previously.
There's a bigger... Oh, yeah. You got a fan letter. I'm a professional race car driver, Hank Wright 28. This is my first fan letter, so forgive me if it's hard to read.
I am writing it while turning left at extreme speeds.
I always use your racing game to practice a new track before actually getting into my car.
That seems bad. Ours is about ninjas.
I run very quickly. Thanks to you, I was able to come in 16th in the recent Chimpin Island race. I recommend your game to all my friends. Hooray!
One girl liked us.
Yay! It was me.
It was you the whole time.
Oh look, see, it just needed a bit of a warm up. The second week had better sales.
Yeah, I think the third week's just gonna slump back down though.
Yeah, we're still gonna hit over 80k though.
It is
pretty good.
We're making that money.
Oh yeah.
Let's train someone.
Good idea.
Who do we want to train?
Oh shit.
Codare?
I think.
Designer.
We've been doing great on music, so we got plenty of sound, so we should increase our scenario and program.
Okay, sure. Let's go with scenario.
Alright.
Hey, John? No, let's actually send you to AnimeCon this time instead of what I did last time, where you came back screaming about samurai.
Boom, boom, boom!
Good for you. And what was the other one you wanted?
Program.
Program. A noob. Do we also want to send noob sure. to AnimeCon?
They've both gone to DragonCon.
They both went to DragonCon. They came back with a bunch of like titty sculptures and very little else.
And a dragon.
And a dragon. And that's good. What else do we want?
We can probably start on another contract now.
Oh, contract's a good idea. We're not low on money, but...
Well, we're not making a lot of profit off of this one either.
We can make a game scenario for someone else.
Mm-hmm.
Or we can...
Or sex for cartoon.
That does say sound effects. But I don't know. I'm not willing to work for hentai. Actually, should we take a stop here?
Sure.
Because it is 10:09.
Okay. Let's take a break.
Yeah, we're going to take a quick break. I want to talk to you a little bit before we go into the break about something important, and that is that Black Lives Matter, that Indigenous lives matter, and that the lives of people of color matter. Protests are ongoing in this country and around the world as Black people, Black Americans in this country are fighting for basic human dignity and equal treatment under the law, which they shouldn't have to fight for, but have had to ever since this country's inception. We would like to bring your attention to some organizations underneath the Bang. Oops, sorry, I bumped the thing. Underneath the Bang donate link, there are some links to the Bail Fund Network, the Ochre Project, Black Trans Travel Fund, and the Black Hills Legal Defense Fund, which are helping protesters with bail, which is helping Black, trans, and non-binary people getting food and rides out of dangerous situations, and helping the Lakota Sioux people fight for their land back, the land that white people use dynamite to carve some shitty people's faces in, and now they call it Mount Rushmore. Underneath Bang Taylor are organizations that are directly helping people affected by the death of Breonna Taylor, a Black woman who was shot to death in her home by police during a botched raid. That's hideous. And it is everyone's fight to make sure that we live in a world where stuff like this is unheard of. Make a commitment to fight white supremacy wherever you find it, globally, locally, and within yourself. That's it. We're gonna run some ads. It'll be about 3 to 5 minutes. Block them if you want. Stand
block
up.
Our ads.
Block our ads. God damn it. Stand up. Sorry. Stand up, get some water, stretch about, do whatever you want to, and we'll see you back here after the break.
All right, we're back.
We're back. We're live, pal.
Bop, 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 bop.
Do we want to work on these sex cartoons or no?
Sure.
Let's work on these sex cartoons.
All right.
I imagine this is just us, like, tuning very finely the ki-ku-ku-ku-ku that makes the Transformers transform.
Yes.
Excuse me, I'm John Gameson.
Oh, okay, and not Vicky Guerrero.
Excuse me.
I used to have a pin that I got from Pro Wrestling Tees as like a blind box thing. That's just Vicky Guerrero's head with the big like cow thing that said "Excuse me." I think I lost it in a game of poker.
Aww.
You want
to sound boost?
No, it's a contract job. I'm not spending research on a contract job, John. We've got this. Just believe in yourself.
Come on, John. You know better than this.
If you have good ideas, leave them for our internal projects, John. I appreciate your go-get'em lifestyle, but we need to really... People were median on the whole Ninja Racer, so...
The work for the sex cartoon is now complete.
We'll definitely work together again. Here
Hooray!
We go. What do we want to do?
Alright, let's...
Let's look
let's
at our new
do
games.
This. Yeah. How much does a contract for the game child cost?
Oh, that's a good question.
Because this console is on the way out.
The console is on the way out. It's only got 15% of market share.
Yeah.
550, which is a lot, but...
We can do another contract job to make up the difference?
No, I think if we cut ourselves down from big budget
something
to
small.
Normal, then it'll right. be it'll be fine.
All right.
Or... Thank you for applying to develop for the game kit. I'm Nintendo Consultant, License Negotiator. It looks like you've got enough capital. I'll give you a license and development kit. Please develop some games that will help promote our console.
I'm Bob, your license.
Oh no, it costs $250 just to develop for it.
Yeah, we're gonna have to...
Let's take another contract real quick.
Yep.
It's fine. It's cool. It's like this sometimes. We're just gonna do some part work. This is not a lot of money.
Scenario 30-20 versus... 25. Okay, Pinball Movie will probably be quicker.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's. That'll hopefully be enough to just get us some quick.
Yeah.
We just knock out something quick and dirty and cheap.
Yeah.
And it'll be just fine. And we'll get some more research points during that time. So that's good.
Yeah.
I wonder if maybe we should look into hiring better staff.
What we need is to have an armored core so that then we can just make whatever games we want.
That sounds like you're doing a funny joke, but I don't understand it.
Oh, that's From Software pre-Demon Souls.
Oh, okay.
They had Armored Core, which was their moneymaker, and then other than that, they just make whatever they wanted.
Oh, hey. That makes sense.
And so that's why we got games like Kingsfield and Eternal Ring that are just fucking wild.
Huh. Alright. I knew, I guess, that Armored Core was a FromSoft joint. I didn't know that it was, I didn't know that it was that.
Yeah, nowadays they have Dark Souls, which...
Uh-oh.
They make that and nothing else, which
Uh-oh.
Is a damn shame.
Uh-oh, we had to pay everybody. That's not what I wanted.
Turns out.
It turns out we had to pay everyone.
Yeah.
Which is good.
Might have to do another contract.
Yeah, it's good. I'm glad we're paying everyone. If we don't... Yeah.
Hey, Riz.
Hi, Riz.
Our fan base is aging.
You've got a fair number of younger fans. If you take advantage of this, you may be able to expand your entire fan base.
I mean, it's only been 4 years. They haven't aged that much.
Is Armored Core the one where you need thermal energy, which is somehow distinct from heat?
Yes.
Huh. Irk. Needed to readjust myself in my chair.
Andy.
Andy.
Oh, we've lost some fans. They died because they turned 42.
You know, 42-year-olds don't play video games.
Mm-hmm.
That's just fact. What do you mean I missed the deadline? Oh, no!
Oh, shit. That's no good.
We were, like, one point off.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Do we want to make something for the PC real quick?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, let's just make a PC game real quick to make money.
7% share. Ouch.
Don't worry about it. It's fine. Here's... make a nice educational game.
Oh, I was thinking a trivia game.
A nice trivia game. A nice movie... a nice boring movie trivia game.
There you go.
Everyone loves movie trivia.
That costs more money than we have.
It costs more money than we have.
This is our last... this is our last ditch
this
effort.
This is our last stand.
If Final Fantasy isn't successful, we're shutting the doors.
We have to do something other than movies because it costs too much.
That's what I'm saying.
Table reversey. Just a regular, honest game. It's Othello, and it's fine.
Okay.
It's just, don't worry about it. It's really Othello up in here.
Realistic Othello.
Innovation? Nope. Very realistic Othello action.
All right. With a physics engine.
Yeah, that's fine. Hey, John.
You're gonna write our story for Reversey.
Yeah, it's good.
A Reversey story. We'll call it Reversey Story. It's a Cairo soft joint.
This should be a popular combination.
No shit.
I really hope so, because we are desperately hurtling towards the red. Okay, so it's, no, salesman, don't come over here. We don't have anything for you. Salesman?
Base it on Shakespeare's Othello. There you go.
Yeah. Isn't that why Othello was called Othello?
Excuse me!
Oh, no, Anne, no, we don't have the money, Anne. I'm sure you'd be great at it, Anne. We don't have the money.
She would. She'd just dig into that shit.
She would be so good at it. We don't have the money. Who should we put in charge of character design? Callie, I guess. Oh, hang on. That's a good one.
Deeply in debt and a quarter of the population is on fire. Yep, that's about right.
Listen... it's not my fault that I never learned how to place public structures and no one has any fire coverage. That's the game's fault for not tutorializing well.
One of the, like, SimCity frustrates the hell out of me because its economic structure is based on some really bad and, like, provably wrong economics textbooks that basically say if your taxes are high, everything's going to fall apart. So if you try and increase your taxes to a reasonable level to help everyone for social programming, literally the streets start exploding.
Oh, yeah.
It's really awful.
Do you think we can underflow our money, get so in the red that we flip back to 999999999K?
Ooh.
I don't want to try.
Sound time.
Yep.
Anne, let's do this.
Yep, sure. Let's Anne do it. It's finally my turn to be a bat. So no word of a lie.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing that just kind of lives in my head constantly is from a Reversey game based on 7-Up.
Mm-hmm. I think I remember that.
You remember the Cool Spot?
Mm-hmm.
The 7-Up logo mascot, Cool Spot?
Mm-hmm.
He had a Reversey game.
Yeah, I think I remember that. I think they like, advertised that you could download it or play it at 7-Up.
No, this was on, like, NES. It was...
oh, wow.
It was in a group of other games. Or it might have been SNES. And the, like, fanfare when you got a big flip just is in here.
Oh, it's a $25, or it was a $25 game. Okay, that's where I was remembering the advertising. It was a mail-in promotion.
Oh, that makes sense.
And it was called Spot the Video Game.
We drank a lot of 7-Up. Actually, I think I might have gotten this from as a, like, rental, now that I'm looking at it.
Gameplay is based on a smaller scale concept of the board game Go, etc., etc.
Yeah.
two to four players, alternated turns, something in a while.
We're losing fans because we haven't put out a game in a while.
Ah.
Yeah. Which is the danger is when you go all in on contracts.
Ah.
It's not a huge bump down, but it's not good.
Mm-hmm.
We're about to ship this, so it's fine for a given value of fine. What's our reverse yin called?
Shakespeare in the Park? I don't know.
Shakespeare in, no, Shakespearean.
Then you gotta remove the E.
Nope.
Shakespeare,
No, I don't. We're sending it to the printers like this because this is how much of a panic we're in. Good idea. I enjoyed it. Good overall.
What the heck is this?
It's,
I don't like complicated strategy board games.
The scores are pretty low, but ooh, hang on. Let's throw out some advertising real quick. Before it goes on sale. Do we want to just throw radio ads at the problem? Magazine ads. Cheapest. Yeah. Hey, Alma. Pokemon Iago is very good. I'm sorry I didn't see that. It's more important that it be trademarkable than correct.
That's true.
That's the spin.
Ooh, a fan letter.
Letter from an adult.
No name. Just someone who's ashamed that they play video games.
I'm an adult.
Hello. I, an adult, have been a fan of truck entertainment for quite some time. Ever since I read about Shakespearean in a magazine, I can't wait to get one of these Shakespearean games. I like table games in general, and I really enjoyed that this one was a reversey game. I have recommended your company as an adult to all of my adult friends, so please work hard on your next adult game.
Nope, different thing. We're not making fucking bubble bath babes over here.
Hey, we already did sex cartoons.
So maybe we don't have a leg to stand on, but I don't want to release like Peek and Poke or whatever.
All right.
See,
we're popular with old people.
Yep. You know what old people love? They love
Versi.
They love playing Go outside digitally.
Shakespearean's first week's 31,309 units.
I'm so glad Anna Adult is a fan. Number 17.
All right, we're still in the top 20, even with a plain old Othello game.
17 is better than the, 25 we were at before? I didn't know it went that low, honestly. I thought it was top 20. That's, you know, that money looks fine.
Yeah, we're actually getting back to where we can release another game right about now.
Yeah, I was thinking this entire time that this was for the...
Let's get started.
Yeah, that this was for the game kit. I forgot this was a PC game.
Mm-hmm.
I think we did about as well as we could.
All right, game kit.
Let's make something for the game child. We could make a trivia game. Mm-hmm. We could make an adventure game. We could make a puzzle game.
Yeah.
Puzzle games on handhelds are good.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh no, I just imagined Othello Battle Royale and my soul went to space. You drop 99 black and white chips in the middle of the table.
Auto-reversey.
I hate that you've said that. What kind of puzzle do we want to make?
Oh, let's see.
Animal puzzle.
Ooh, animal puzzle.
I like animal puzzles.
Me too.
So when we say animal puzzle, let's not big budget that.
Let's look at direction. What else can we do in there?
Speed. Don't worry about quality. I hate that because you end up spending so much time squashing bugs.
Yeah.
That it doesn't matter. Quality can be slower, but breakthroughs are more likely. We kind of need to make money quick.
I don't know. We'd make more money with a lot of breakthroughs.
Maybe you're right. What would that put us at? $399?
Mm-hmm.
And I think we have to hire out one or two.
I think that's good. I think we're good.
Okay. So our puzzle animal game has to be very cute.
Yep.
That's really what we're saying here.
Yeah.
I think it needs to be approachable.
Yeah. Drop down the niche appeal a bit.
Yeah, actually, let's drop both of those.
Yeah, this looks pretty good. This looks pretty good. I like this.
I like that we have a dot and everything, but then we're just switching around other stuff.
Yeah.
An animal puzzle game. So are we trying to match animals to each other?
Maybe we're trying to get animals to not eat each other.
Oh, I like that. Yeah. Kind of a reverse cubivore.
Yeah, there you go.
Or a zoo simulator, but the last person to pay a pound of flesh wins in the Othello Battle Royale is what Alma just said, and I don't know. I've hated other stuff. Voxel, the cubic box stacking game.
Oh, I actually like that.
Or like Alpha Bears.
Mm-hmm.
We have to do this, right? We have to do the 10K because I don't think we can afford more than 100K.
Yeah. Yeah, probably.
You're a boat. You have a fox, a hen, and a cricket, and you have to help them cross a stream.
That's what I was thinking, too.
The fox will eat the hen will eat the cricket, and the cricket will...
Eat the boat.
Eat the boat, yeah. Crickets are mean. I don't know if you know that about crickets. They're so fucking mean.
Crickets. Their songs are pretty as long as they're in chorus. If there's one cricket, it will piss you off. Game development. Yeah, we've been making fun of that since the start. Like, it's not a great port overall.
There's sort of word rap, but it doesn't work all the time, and it feels weird to me. I don't know a lot about game development or game development, but... That seems like it's weird to happen, to do happen.
Mm-hmm.
Puzzle has increased to level 2.
Hooray! Level 2 puzzle!
And we can have 2 more points for the game's direction when we get back around to that.
See, I knew quality was a good path.
Callie wants to try increasing the creativity of our game. It would...
We could hit 80%.
We could hit 80%.
With 66.
Actually, if we have 83 fucking research data, we should maybe just level some people up real quick.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's not do that and instead just level people up midstream.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's 25 apiece. We could actually only get 3. No. That's what, 75 and then 90? So 95, it wouldn't get to 100. We also wouldn't be able to get it for everyone. So actually,
since our next up is the graphics and sound, let's focus on the artists.
Yeah, let's get Callie and dinged out. That's what they call it.
Yep, dinged up.
That's what I've called it my whole life.
Yep. There we go.
46, it sounds like good sounds.
Uh-huh.
Let's leave everything else. We'll come back around to it, like, at the end of this process.
Shakespearean is now off the market. That's not how this works.
Life genre.
Ooh.
Is now unlocked, so we can do a life game.
Alright, about life.
Who should we put in charge of graphics? Callie could do it again.
Has she only done it once in a row?
Yeah.
Okay. That sounds good, then.
This is my big chance.
I wish it would say previous 2 or something once you've done it twice, because the third time is when she gets tired.
I mean, that wasn't great.
Yeah.
It could be better.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably fine.
No bugs so far.
No bugs.
Oh,
I guess that's...
Yeah,
okay,
that's what
cool.
I get. That's what I get.
Absolutely cursed. Why are you like this?
Nice.
So what is this? Is this Alpha Bear, or is this a Keep Animals from Eating Each Other simulator?
How about all of the above?
Okay. We keep animals from eating each other by building walls of progressively longer words.
Which, once you spell out fox, they turn into foxes.
That's the secret. That's the secret tech.
Yeah.
Okay.
In the end, you want a wall of fox boxes.
Sound time.
We just have Callie do it. We could have Anne do it again.
Sure.
I think we should let Callie do it.
Alright. It's finally my turn up at bat.
You know, I got into this business to be a sound engineer, but...
Damn!
Well... Sure. Good. This is perfectly okay as a release.
Uh-huh.
Oh, Callie wants another pass at the sound.
Ooh, good. Good.
It's like, I didn't feel like I did it good. We can turn it
up to a coin flip. I say go for it.
Really?
Yeah.
All of our research.
Let's do it.
Big swings.
Okay,
well. This better be 36, so we can get it back. No.
Look at all those Dr. Mario Viry.
It's fine. Oh, they are kind of Dr. Mario Viry.
Mm-hmm. This game's gonna have all kinds of sound glitches now.
No, because we're gonna get rid of them before we ship it. Because we're responsible. We could rush it out the door, but we're not going to. We would rather
Look! I see.
We would rather not assault our players. Oh yeah, so we do get research data when like, our teams are working closely together, which is good.
Mm-hmm. Do, do, do.
Da, da, da.
Do, do, do.
Is this music
do, do,
bad for
do,
people?
Do, do. I like it.
I don't think it's awful or anything, but it is this same track.
Mm-hmm.
Like, a lot. Like,
forever.
A lot of it. It is sort of this one same track forever.
I mean, so is Luigi's Mansion 1.
Okay, that's fair. Let's change our title to... What is it? Box Word Box?
I liked Foxel.
Foxel. Voxels, I think. What is that? Voxels hadn't been invented in 1980-whatever. Don't fucking worry about it.
Game Kid Foxels.
Game Kid Foxels.
Bum, 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 bum.
Good. I'm glad we got there.
It's an interesting idea. Look forward to a sequel. Rethink the combination. Not bad, but not great.
Do we want to throw some advertising at it real quick?
Yeah.
We do have a little bit of money still.
We got the cash.
We got the quiche.
We got the quiche.
We can just throw a demo out there?
Sure.
Or we can hire a marching band. We can't. That's expensive.
All right. That's a big increase because everyone got to play Foxels.
They got to play the first, like, five iterations of Foxels before it gets really hard. They got to play up to the first level where you have the fox stacks.
And does all the intro stories and then plays the credits like the Wild Arms 2 demo.
Yeah.
Number 8.
Yeah, we cracked the top 10.
Take that. Baba is us.
Baba is us.
Look at that. We've hit 100K in our second week.
We're a whole bobble company sales record.
Hell yes.
Everything's looking up.
Ooh.
The magazine wrote an article about foxes. Because everyone loves animals.
It's this game where you take these foxes and you make them into walls.
You turn fox into wall, and it's the best thing I've ever played. You get like four kids with a shitty link cable thrown out of a homeroom for playing foxholes during class.
Mm-hmm. They thought they could hide the link cable under a backpack.
But no, no. They know, the adults. We've got quite a lot of cash at our disposal now, but you still have to be careful about how you use your funds. Consider investing in advertising to expand your fan base and secure the company's future.
End of this month is also salary.
End of this month is also salary, but I think we have, like, we have enough right now to pay for that and still be over 1,000.
Mm-hmm.
Do we want to just jump right into the next project?
Yeah. All right. Do another Game Kid game.
That does seem like it's smashing the box offices.
Yeah. You always want to go for whatever has a high market share.
Yeah. So we unlock the life thing.
Yeah, sure. Let's do a life.
I don't quite know what that means. Still?
The Sims.
Like The Sims.
The Sims. With
do a historical life game.
Ooh, that's a good idea. I like that.
Or a movie life game.
I like historical life.
Or a marathon life game.
It's just Halo as The Sims.
It's just Halo, but The Sims now.
Master Chief Master Chief keeps setting his omelets on fire.
Oh no, that's a bit from Frog Fractions 3.
Mm-hmm.
Letterman and Grove has that minigame.
Where Master Chief sets his omelet on fire?
So it's called Spraxis, and that means something, and I forget what it stands for. But the idea is that you are a space marine rooming with a xenomorph.
That. Yeah, I remember that.
And your job is to annoy the xenomorph into leaving.
Be passive-aggressive until he leaves.
Yeah, you be passive-aggressive.
And there's not a way to win, because no matter what, you realize you're the asshole.
Yeah. Which I guess is a kind of winning. Do you want to go with quality?
Yeah, I like how quality went.
Okay, so historical life game.
Realism!
Yeah, if it's historical, we kind of probably want realism in there.
We're gonna put people of color in our historical game.
Yeah. You know, like they really were.
Uh-huh.
Fucking literally every game company.
Fucking hell.
Polish? Niche appeal? Innovation?
Maybe drop down approachability a point and put it in a niche.
Yeah, a little bit.
I think this looks pretty good. No, this isn't civilization. This is simulation.
I'm annoyed that you've said that. But now that's the name of the game.
Shipwrecked. You have a random crew, resources, and an island to explore. Your goal, survive until you're rescued or until you no longer have to be rescued. Well, that's pretty cool.
So there's this game that I enjoyed playing called Discourse.
Mm-hmm.
D-Y-S-C-O-U-R-S-E. Mm-hmm. That's basically that. Uh-huh. It's more story-based than that. What Alma described was sort of a simulation. This is a narrative thing.
Mm-hmm.
But it's about being shipwrecked with, like, 8 people and, like, making decisions to see who survives.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoyed playing it, and it's got a lot of replayability. And then they release some free DLC that's the same thing, except all of the people you got shipwrecked with were indie game developers.
Oh, I remember this.
Yeah, it's like John Blow and Edmund McMillan and, what's his fucking name? Phil Fish.
Mm-hmm. Everyone votes to kill Phil Fish.
Listen, he had a rough time of it.
I know.
I'm not here to actually, like, defend him much.
He is not well liked at this point.
No, he is we could just have John do it.
Sounds
good. Hey, John, do the thing.
He came up with a great idea.
Let's get some sensitivity readers in here for John.
For our white guy literally named John Gameson.
Yeah, let's get some sensitivity readers in here.
Alright.
That's a good idea.
You did good.
Okay.
Ooh, there we go. There we go. Here we go. Yeah, get it done.
That is getting it done. I'll tell you what. Oh, wow. It's about time to move to a different office and expand the size of your company.
600K, we can afford it.
We can afford that.
Let's do it.
Let's go to a bigger office.
That'll get us more employee space.
You have moved to a new office.
Hooray. Fez is a good game.
Fez is an incredible game. It's so fucking good.
It's Super Paper Mario, but it's Super Paper Mario.
Yeah.
it's Super Paper Mario's main mechanic to a bigger level.
Perhaps it should be noted, this is one of those things that it's not like he made the whole game himself.
Yeah. Not even close.
Yeah.
And we really need to not ever do that with any game. Pretend that there's one person behind it.
Yeah.
Unless it's Cave Story.
Unless it's Cave Story and literally Pixel did every single fucking thing by themselves.
Uh-huh.
We'll worry about hiring more people later.
The latest issue of Gamagooey, moving to bigger diggers.
Truck Entertainment is riding Teehee Wave by its recent success by moving to larger offices. Their new headquarters are said to be twice as big as the old ones, and the desks, chairs, and other furnishings are all brand new. And DeRoy, one of their employees, had this to say about their new digs. It's a wonderful office. I can't wait to come here every day and start to work making great games.
I have to assume that it was previously owned by Dig Dug.
By Doug Digger.
Yeah. Thanks to the article, Truck Entertainment's fan base throughout the country has increased.
Pretty sure the Dwarf Fortress guy did everything but the music, which his brother did.
Mm.
That sounds correct.
Well, they both work on it together, and there's also a lot of, there's like a community that helps work on it as well.
That's true. Did you name all these people, or are they default names? They are default names, and they are all like this.
Yep.
They are all Ace Attorneys.
Yep. Noob.
Noob. Please. Please, for my family.
Excuse me. I'd like to try increasing the sound.
No.
You're not that good at sound,
no, John.
John.
I'm not even going to look at it, John.
Oh, yeah, we can hire a new person.
We can hire two new people.
Uh-huh.
I want to wait for our light game to go out.
Alpha version's finished.
Callie did the last one, so we should probably get Jake?
Mm-hmm.
We can't hire Quinn.
Yeah, Jake sounds good.
We did earlier turn down outsourcing content to Big Porkins, if I recall correct. Big's Porkins.
Big's Porkins, yeah.
Big Porkins! Hey there, friends. Big Porkins here for Big Porkins Carne Asada.
Big Porkins is Star Wars and Carne Asada. What
Jake?
Is this song?
Jake?
Is this our new music?
We have new music now that we're in the high rise.
Yeah.
That's nice. I'm glad it's not the same music.
Uh-huh. I didn't remember the music change.
I think it might not have done.
Yeah.
I think they might have changed this.
That's possible.
Then again, I'm thinking about it, and I didn't really play this with the sound on.
Mm-hmm. I did.
Like, this is something I played on a bus, and I was trying to, like, not upset people. I don't think we can buy anything right now.
No, and the costs go up each year.
Oh, right. Well.
Which is why I thought we should buy them earlier.
Well. I mean, we had enough money troubles that I'm glad we didn't do the thing we did.
Mm-hmm. All right, beta complete. We're staying at the British way.
Bounds.
All right.
All right, Anne.
Do, 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 do,
it's a historical game about history. That's fine. We should probably spend some ad money.
Yeah.
This looks like we should maybe spend some ad money. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Sega is announcing their new console.
Oh no, the Play Gear. They're trying to compete, but it's going to fail miserably without our help.
Yeah. It's a portable console with a color LCD screen. The portable game market is about to expand. Like your collection of AA batteries. increasing the creativity. I don't think that's...
Yeah, that's not going to do it for...
Yeah, I think that ain't it.
Oh.
Like, we
Shit!
We could take the gamble, but we need to sort of pump out a hit right here.
Mm-hmm.
They're quashing bugs. I think this is a good time to do advertising.
Yeah.
Do we want to just do online ads?
Yeah, that sounds good to me.
I don't want to go so far in that we...
Only teenagers and middle-aged women use the internet.
Yeah, that sounds right. But yes, thank you. It's a portable game console. Uh-oh. I almost jostled the cartridge. It's fine. A representative from GameDex 2S asked us if we wanted to have a booth at the show. We absolutely are not going to be able to afford this.
They should be paying us.
Yeah. We can't attend the show. I thought it would be a goody chance to make out with our names out, but there we are.
To make out with
Don't
our names
worry
out.
About it. I said the thing I said and I stand by it. I hope we'll be able to attend next year. That's the banner. That's the banner that we put over our booth. Make out with your games out. Well, you know, sometimes words just kind of get away from you.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's like that. Did we discuss what the fuck this game was about?
Nope.
Okay.
I don't even remember what this game was.
Me neither, to be honest with you. It's been so long, it feels like it's been 1,000 years. Oh, this is the historical life game.
Right.
So this is The Sims. No, it was... What was it called? Simvilization. You said a thing.
Simulivations, I believe is what I actually said.
Simulivation. Okay, got it. Ship it, cut it, print it. Simulivation. Like Alma said, it doesn't matter that it doesn't make sense. It matters that it's copyrightable.
Oh, you missed an I.
No, I didn't. L-I-V-I?
T-I-O-N.
A-T-I-O. Simulivation.
Yeah.
So it's an elevation sim?
It's about the creation of elevators.
It's about terrain heights.
It's about the creation of elevators and their safety mechanisms.
It's about Upsy, your lifting friend.
Yep.
Good, but limited appeal.
Upsy and Downzo.
Those aren't great scores.
We never get great scores.
No, we don't get great scores.
We're FromSoft before 4chan found Dark Souls.
There's just a few of us who love what we do, and we do, mm-hmm. and they do. We are almost 50,000 on the day.
Yeah. Number 12, but that's not good enough in today's market.
We didn't crack the top 10, but do we want to run a fucking contract real quick?
Might as well.
While we wait for this to sort out. Minigames?
Nice quick one.
Oh no, we shouldn't do that. Instead of that, we should do hiring.
Ah yes, we should get a new person.
We could run a magazine ad.
Sure.
Let's see how this runs.
Alright, we're over 100k again.
We got 4 applicants.
Decoder.
Who's a designer.
She was not a coder.
A very good designer, actually.
Uh-huh.
And that might be useful.
Yeah.
Oh, we have a director.
Oh, hey.
Shigeto Minamoto. You know, the director, Shigeto Minamoto.
Shigeto Minamoto.
Amy Less.
We could use that director. I think we should do that.
I absolutely think we should get Shigeto Minamoto on our side.
Yeah, he can create Mario for us.
And
that's that designer who's actually pretty cheap.
A very cheap, quite good designer.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, there we go. We're full. Morning!
New genres!
Simulation and sim RPG.
Hurrah! So I think we're in the middle of a contract right now.
No.
No, I said we were going to, and then we did.
Well, we can still run one.
Yeah, let's do that real quick. Make mini games.
Ooh, yeah, I think we can do that with all the people we got now.
Oh right, now that we have deadline is 6 weeks. I also noticed that before clicking it, and uh-oh.
All right. Let's give it a shot.
Meow.
All right, come on.
Clickety click, 66.
Come on, Callie, you can do it.
Yeah. California, here we come.
Yep. Hold me closer, California.
Oh, that's almost that hole.
Yeah.
Good.
Oh, there we go. Got some coding breakthroughs going on. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, the director came through on the coding.
Oh, good. Paying dividends.
And we just doubled our money.
Yeah. So let's... Do we want to try and...
Let's put out another one.
This will be our last game, probably.
Yeah.
Because it's starting to get a little late.
Yeah.
We still want to do for the GameKid? GameKid does still have the most market
share.
Yeah,
let's go for it.
So, yeah.
We'll be known as like, the greatest development studio for the GameKid of all time.
It's one of those things like, oh, yeah, I remember all those great games for the GameKid, like Final Fantasy and Golden Sun and
Voxel.
And Voxel. I was like, what, those were all by the same devs? Mm-hmm. What? We could do a sim or a sim RPG.
Cool, let's do a sim RPG.
Sim RPG.
The GameKid needs more of those.
Sure, not historical, though.
Historical sim RPG could be.
Maybe. I kind of want something
pirate
else.
Sim RPG.
Pirate
or
sim.
Or samurai.
I like pirate.
Okay.
Pirate sim RPG. Do we want to stay on quality?
Yeah.
Okay. For pirate.
Lower something in favor of game world.
Yeah,
probably
I was thinking
realism.
That. Yeah, probably realism.
Realism is not that fun in sim RPGs.
Maybe like that.
Mm-hmm.
Around a little bit.
I was gonna say lower realism in favor of polish.
Oh, okay.
So we want a good old fantasy world going on.
I think that's good.
Yeah. Like how Rare developed all these cutesy games, but also a bloody gory fighting game and a game about nuking America. They just did stuff. Yep.
Yeah. It just did. So what's the game about nuking America?
Also, they were called Ultimate Play the Game.
Like, no, but what is that game?
I don't know what one she's referring to.
Okay. Oh, we can have Minamoto-san write it for us.
Oh, yeah.
That sounds good.
Yeah. He's very creative. Blast Corps, okay. I thought that game was mostly about, like, trucks breaking stuff.
That's also what I thought Blast Corps was about. I've not played it myself.
Uh-huh.
Simulation just went off the market.
But it had a good sales run.
It did have a great sales run.
It turns out all we needed was a bigger office. I mean, if you play well, it's about vehicles wrecking stuff. Okay.
Or...
I was afraid I was misremembering it entirely.
Or...
Pirates, level 2.
Or there's other stuff that the game could be about.
The alpha version, character design.
Callie. Actually, we have that new designer. D.
Alright, D. Let's do this.
Let's roll it up, light it up, D.
It's not actually free. We are paying her salary.
Yeah, but we don't have to pay her extra salary. Although maybe we should have.
Oh yeah, we probably should have leveled her up, huh?
Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
You can do that right now.
No, but I don't want to right now. I like our sound engineers.
The microsex is going to be discontinued.
You can't develop games for consoles that are no longer in the market, so be careful.
One of them old 8-bit micros.
It has like a cassette tape reader in it. I don't know if you saw the picture.
It is literally an 8-bit microcomputer.
Yeah. Pan.
Allie.
Or Beethoven.
Beethoven.
Mozart.
Mozart and Beethoven. Oh, and Wolfgang Smith. Who is also Mozart.
Yeah.
There are two Mozarts here. Callie's low on energy.
The kid doesn't.
Anne has already done it twice in a row.
Yeah. Muse Ignorgatius.
Muse Ickle Genius. let's hire one of the... Let's hire Mozart.
Sure. Let us try and get a pirate game.
Alright, not
that,
bad.
That could be worse. Allie would like to try and increase the creativity of our game in development.
Not really her specialty.
Not really her specialty. We don't really have enough.
It's funny because Noob keeps wanting to do music and then Callie keeps wanting to do creativity, and they should really switch those out.
Yeah, but we don't want to buy that many game manuals.
The game under development is now complete.
We did say Microsoft.
Yeah. There are two Mozarts inside you. God, I hope not. He was a bitter, angry man, from everything I understand.
Now we will start the debugging process.
Makes sense, because he was frustrated with the horrible commercialization that was going on with music in the classical era, where all music sounded the same. Marching bands.
You
want to
just throw
fuck?
Out some TV ads?
I say we do the demo again. A little less expensive and was very effective.
Yeah.
Plus, you know, it draws in girls 19 to 24. Who are our biggest demographic now.
Yeah. So we're doing something right.
Uh-huh.
Oh no, it's time for the Global Game Awards.
Oh no, we're gonna be told our games are terrible by a Razer.
We're
This was a real thing that happened.
Yeah, I know. I'd blissfully forgotten about the giant Razer. They'll be giving a number of awards to game release this year. We have two games up for consideration.
Best design.
Design.
Omega Man, very nice.
Towervania.
By Lame O Games. Best music. Panic the Prairie Dog.
By Senga. It was at the fucking...
I saw Foxholes on there.
Yeah. Hot Shots Gorilla by Sony. Before we round the grand prize, we must announce the worst game award with a penalty of $300,000.
I don't think that's how that works.
I think that's not how that works. Unfortunately, our game isn't up on there.
Cheetah win. Nice. Okay, maybe Cheetah Men deserved to be fined $300,000.
Try not to receive that one again. Now the grand prize. I don't think we're on here. Foxholes is in there, but it's not us.
Brain Strainer DX. That's the director's cut.
Yep, that's what that means.
I mean, it is.
Oh, I thought it meant deluxe.
Didn't mean either.
Okay. Okay, so we didn't win any awards our fifth year in, but that's fine.
The awards didn't exist till now, so it's cool. They just suddenly came in and acted like they'd always been there.
Badroot says cheetahs never prosper, which is...
And winners don't do drugs?
Which is a thing you can say. What do we want to call our pirate sim RPG?
Oh, RPG.
Good.
Now we're out of space.
No, wait, hang on. Yes.
Capital B, capital G.
Sorry, capital P, capital G.
Good.
Well, this is what I wanted. How many R's is that?
All of them.
Every last one.
That is 29 R's.
Doesn't even fit on the reviews.
I like this kind of game. Close, try harder. Too short! Dude, it was 95 hours.
Let's see how it goes.
It literally doesn't fit. It's missing the beginning.
Minor Magazine wrote an article about RPG. That should slightly increase our sales. I guess I'll do the outro while we see how well RPG does.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been Christy, joined by Katie.
Whoa.
We're two of five women who stream here on Squirrel Lily. twitch.tv/squirrellily, although you can also find us at truck.community. And we stream 6 days a week, so if you want to interact with the follow button in some way, you can see when we go live. That'll let you know when we do stuff. Let's run down the schedule real quick. So tomorrow is Tuesday. That'll be Andrea playing more Makitoshi Saga 2.
Just Saga 2. Makitoshi Saga is specific to the first game.
God damn it. I spent all that time learning how to say it. She'll be playing more Saga 2. The one where you punch God.
I mean, you punch God in, like...
A lot of RPGs.
Not only that, but just a lot of the Saga games.
It was number 6.
Hihu Densetsu.
She'll be playing the second Saga game for the Game Boy, because there was the re-release on Switch, so she's going to play that. That's Tuesday. Wednesday is going to be Sue and Mox playing more Monster Hunter World. They're in Iceborne now. Everyone's concerned about how cold the handler is. We're all worried. It's okay. We can all be worried together. After that is...
She's with the tracker now. It's fine.
She's with the tracker now. Mm-hmm. Is the tracker the hot grandma?
Yeah.
The hot, strong grandma?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Thursday is Alice, and Alice will be playing some video game. She will be playing the Paper Mario Origami King. A game about Paper Man in a paper world, he screams, for he does not know.
Apparently Japan is just going to be announcing a new console.
A whole new console just from the island nation of Japan, the PCC FQX. I don't know what this is meant to be a reference to.
PC Engine.
I've never known. Oh, PC Engine.
That's my best guess. Or maybe the MSX?
That makes sense.
It's got 6 buttons, though.
So after that is... that's Paper Mario on Thursday with Alice. After that is Katie. On Friday, you're playing the other Mario game, Super Mario...
Thick Mario.
Yeah, Thick Mario. Mario 3D World.
Thick Mario in the Thick Realm.
Thick Mario in the Realm of Thickness. As opposed to Paper Mario, which is Thin Mario.
Yep. Wow, we've sold 250,000 games. Except it says there it's 25,000.
I mean, it is over 25,000.
That's true.
It is over 25,000.
I don't recall this typo being here in the original.
I don't either. Let's move on. That'll be Friday with Super Mario 3D World. I didn't actually say it. Plus Bowser's Fury, which she'll get to, presumably.
I think so.
Saturday we don't stream. Sunday's our community day. We're probably going to be playing World War Z, but stay tuned. And then Monday I'll loop back around to me with Hades. I'm going to start Hades next week. We're probably going to come back to this game as like a palate cleanser sort of thing, like we did this week. It's not going to be more of this. It's going to be Hades. I'm excited to play it because I've wanted to play it for a long time.
Hades nuts.
Really? Really? You're going to do that?
Yes.
You're going to do that here?
And I'm proud of myself.
In front of God and everybody? I'm going to start Hades. It's going to be a fun game. We're going to probably not learn that much about Greek mythology. But there will be some hot people in it. We might get to kiss one. We'll see how it goes. And that's that. You can check out our schedule at schedule.truck.community. Not just our schedule, but all of our community's schedules, which is to say... Xenon Fiber, In the Land of the Rising Sun, Andemonium, Bad Road, and Riz Plays Games. All great streamers worthy of your time and attention. If you are looking for other people to follow, they are good people to follow. Please do that thing. Or if you just want to see more of us, we have... if you just want to see us, we have a YouTube, which is at youtube.truck.community. It's all under one umbrella. It's very easy to do. We have... literally thousands of hours of streaming content there because we have been doing this for multiple years. please, if you just want to kill some time, that's not a bad place to do it. And is that everything? Black Lives Matter. Is that everything?
I think that's it.
I've been Christy, and until we see you next time, the Exodus is going to be discontinued in 3 months. Stay safe.